Welcome everyone, hope you are enjoying this little preview of the summit, which is starting soon. We are preparing with the experts something very special for you. From 8 p.m. onwards, they will be all here, whoever can make it, you know, and they will tell you something from far away, from all around the world, some little message that is coming from their heart. So let's wait a little bit from 8 p.m. They will join me in this live show. And until then, let me explain a little bit more about the summit, how you can watch it, because I receive a lot of questions from the participants, how they can watch the events. Because I wanted the summit to be open and to reach more people and to make it like a shareable event, I opened it up. So we created these two links, which are going to my YouTube link and to my Facebook page. So basically, when you are on the website, the links on the website will lead you to the Facebook page. So you exactly can go to the live feed and to the live videos. You even receive some emails if you registered, and from the email directly, you can choose your program. What I would suggest to you is to go to Facebook, check out my Facebook page, Andrea Zsapka, and check the programs that you like. And if you just make them, put them in your calendar and you like them, that you would like to check it later, then it will pop up for you that we are going live. So let me show you the option. I will just share my screen and I will show you all the options how you can watch this summit. So first of all, the most important and the last and the easiest way, like, is to go to the What You Mean Month workshop website, right? So I will share my screen and show you all the different ways of how you can watch this summit, because we want you to watch it. We want you to get all of it, because we really put together a lot of programs together for you with the 108 experts and with all the topics that we will talk about. So let's see, this is the main site. So this is where you registered, and we have the main teaser here, and you can get your free ticket if you still would like to be part of the summit. Feel free to join anytime, you just have to get the ticket and then you will be informed about every event at the summit. So how you can choose your topics, you just have to go to the Watch the Summit option here. And then when you are at the Watch the Summit, you can choose the days. So for example, today is the 1st of October, the first day of the summit. So you can go down here and you can see that you can join now here with the help of the little buttons under all the different events, right? And if you push join now, it will directly go to the Facebook page. So let's see, this part is already over. What will happen? So you see the live show has ended. So you can watch those things which are still on, and you can also see here the videos, so you can watch them again, no problem. So what I would suggest to you is to go back to the website and you can see the program. So for example, what will happen tonight? Let's check it out. So we are already having all these videos. I played it for you. I introduced the experts. Write into the comments which experts did you see, and write a little sentence about them so that I see that you were watching us. And yeah, we were here. Andrea was just doing her empowerment through resilience short webinar for you to bring you up and making you more curious about the topic, because we will talk about resilience a lot. And we were introducing Adriana, Céleste, the award-winning trademark specialist, Pauline Crawford-Omps will be creating a very special webinar for you on Saturday with the Malaysian experts together. It's worth to watch it from 9:30. And Adriana is part of the fashion show. Céleste is doing the business identity session. So there are so many things to do. And here it is. I told you that Pelpina trip is coming. Seven practical tips to make videos with impact using just your phone. So I will play this video for you that she sent to me because she wanted to contribute to the event also. And then here it is at 8 o'clock, we go live with the experts who can join me, and we will have a little surprise for you. And after that, be right aware, go to the first topic, which is our first grand panel discussion about work-life balance, family, business, and education. So we will go around the topic with 8 different experts, with one moderator, and we will talk about it from different angles so that we can see how we can adapt to change and how the dynamism in families and in education and work and home and remote work and homeschooling and everything together, how is it changing? This is from 9 o'clock tonight. It's a bigger panel discussion, it's a longer one. We will have here all the different speakers. And then you have also Vanita's Raw and Uncut show, where I could be a guest, and it was very interesting because we were all different background and from different countries. And you see something very special for you. If you are already registered, you got the email that you can enter this virtual networking link. We partnered up with Reumert, and Reumert is providing us an application, a platform, which is very, very good for business networking. So we will, today we will practice a little bit with it and experiment, and every night it will be with us until Saturday night, where Sunday night we already don't have that. So until Saturday you have to try this out, and after that you can join the day too. So basically this is how you join in. So let me see if I want to join the work-life balance, family, business, and education panel tonight, right? Then I just click on the join now button, and what it will do, it will bring you the exact post, which will go live at 8 p.m. So if you just leave your computer here, or you can even set yourself a reminder and it will pop up on your screen that you like this. And you can just go through the whole program, basically. But what is also a nice tactic, that you check out the program from tomorrow, right? So you will check, for example, day 2. And then you go through the day on the program and you see, oh, I would like to go to have the yoga. So you go on the yoga session, you click on the reminder, and it will pop up on your Facebook page when it's live, and you will see it in this little window. Let's check another one. For example, I would like to see, ooh, Patricia. You must see Patricia. She's an amazing role model and super energetic lady. So for example, I would like to see Patricia too. So I go to the join now button and I get a reminder for Patricia's session too. So whenever tomorrow 9:30 we go live, this will pop up on your Facebook page and you can watch it directly. Let's see whether we have something that you would like to see. We have sustainability. We also have a very funny session from 11 with some surprises that I cannot tell, but the experts will be having a hard time with kids asking very, very crazy questions. And we have young entrepreneurs here. Terry Carrell is an amazing broadcaster, and she is mentoring and helping Livia, who is an entrepreneur already. And we are working with youth volunteers. I have around more than 22 youth volunteers from the INTI school. Thank you very much for the project, and I hope the students are enjoying it. Yes, we have also cooking shows, you see. So Stefan will show you how to eat your way to amazing health every day. And we have also social topics, like how do we empower each other during very difficult times through community effort. And we have also career talks. I just cannot say everything from this because you have to all go through. The digital taboo must be also very interesting. It will be about cyberbullying. Let's be diverse. It's a funny discussion. I attended their trial session. It was really, really funny. All of them are different personalities, so Patrick really made a good job by choosing them. We have Toastmasters on board. So Benicia is one of the Toastmasters, and a few Toastmasters join in, and they will moderate the session. I really appreciate that, because I believe that Toastmastership is a must-do. I was also debating when I was a kid. PR and brand building. We have four amazing ladies in this field. Go and learn from them for half an hour. We have Life After Reboot. This is a session which is bringing together ladies who have been in very difficult situation because of their health, and they all bounce back, and they are all happy, and they are strong, and they are telling about their stories. Fearless Warrior Formula. This is also something that you have to attend. Veronica is a confident lady. She will just make you brave. That's all. How she speaks, how she moves, it's all about confidence. So you will be irresistible when she is taking you into her hands. So creative empowering leadership, very important topic today. We would like to emphasize that how leadership is changing. People realize that the ways are not working anymore. So we have an amazing expert group talking about the topics. We try to get the topics from different angles that no one talks about, so you will get some surprises. And here it comes, the secret rooms. We have cultural differences and ageism, domestic abuse and violence, and sexism and gender issues. For this, you have to go also to this Join Now button, and here it comes, the application or the platform that I was talking about. This is AirMeet. The guys are partnering up with me, and they are supporting us by providing the platform. So AirMeet is an event platform where you can spice up your meetings with the different applications inside. So we will start this cultural differences in 10 hours. It will be on the 2nd of October. You see, it's totally free. You need to register, because we would like to provide security for the people inside. So you have to give real data here. And all the sessions, all these secret rooms from 8 o'clock every day will be like this on this platform. Then we go back to the big panel discussions, generation gap, empowerment, and today your work-life balance. And we will have again some kind of interesting videos. My friend from Portland, she's originally Korean, lived in Malaysia and moved to Portland, Jane. She was so nice and made some interesting pivot interviews with all the experts, so that their own personal stories can inspire you to change. So you see, it's colorful, and I'm just at the second day. So please, please go and check this program out. And I believe this is the most efficient way to watch the summit. Go here, choose your sessions, get a reminder, and when you are on your Facebook, you will get always the reminders about the live shows. So that's my little talk here for today. You can also watch day 3 and day 4. We are here from 7 a.m. until midnight, almost 1 o'clock if the meetings will be good in the networking room. And we will do a lot of activities together. How you can stay in touch with the experts? We are using the comments field under this session. So if you go to Facebook, to your live post, then under that, all the comments, they are coming to our StreamYard. So we will see what you write, and we will answer you back. And even after the sessions, we will go back and we will comment, and we will answer all your questions. So ask a lot of questions, engage, because 108 experts are here just for you, waiting for your questions and trying to give you a colorful weekend with all the things. So let me stop talking. If you still have questions about how to see and how to watch the whole summit, just let me know. You can still write into the comments. And also, please read the emails, because if you registered, you will soon get the second email or third email that we are sending out. So every single day, we will inform you about what's happening the next day. So let's see. I promised the video. So let's go I'm the studio lady here. So let's go back to StreamYard and let's choose this nice video that I wanted to show you today. So I will remove this one. And yeah, I think that will be the tonight's nice surprise from Pelpina. Pelpina Tripp is from the Netherlands, and she is a very famous lady about how she's using her own phone to make beautiful videos, and she helped a lot of people to go budget and to use their phones and cameras much better than I do. All right, so let's see, where is this video? I will just put it in the feed, and then we can watch it together. Let me see. All right, share my screen. This is the thing when we need to be careful. All right. So let me see which one is my teaser. All right. This one. And today I'm practicing all day long so that you will have the maximum support tomorrow when I will all sit all day long, just like now, in front of the camera and give you all the visuals and banners while our super experts are talking. All right. And you see, I can do it too. You can do it too. So we have it here. All right.
Hi, it has never been more important to be visible, to make a connection digitally, and to be able to do that through a camera lens. Well, I'm here today in this session to give you 7 tips on how to make a connection, how to be visible, but in a simple way, by just using your smartphone. Here are 7 tips. Tip number 1, make things visual. We're making a video, not an audio podcast. So let's make sure that you show people what you're talking about. You can do this with a background, a foreground, or perhaps by holding something up in the air, holding something in your hands. So think beforehand, what am I really going to show people? How is this going to be visually interesting? So use the right people in your video, use the right objects or props in your video to make it visually interesting. My second tip is be a person and try to make a connection with someone else. So don't just send out your information, but really think about who is going to be my viewer and what are the topics? What are their questions and problems? What are the things that they are maybe really concerned about right now? And how can I, as a person or as a team, help them and make that personal connection right now? So think about who your viewer is, and then also try to make that connection by having interaction with your video, asking people questions, inviting them to leave a comment, and to replying on that comment as well. Be human. Tip number 3 is make sure you have good audio. If the audio is distracting, maybe there's distracting background noises, a TV that is still on, or a truck that passes by, those can be really distracting. So what I recommend is before you start filming, before you hit record, listen to your surroundings. Make sure that there are no distracting noises. And if there are, try to turn them off if that's possible, or move to another room if that's possible. Of course, you can also use microphones. Well, I'm actually wearing a microphone right now, which this is the Rode SmartLav Plus. It's made for smartphones. You just plug it in and it works. It's amazing. But I also often use these. They're actually 2 wireless. This is a wireless set, which I love as well. So one is a microphone and one, you know, there's a receiver and a sender, and it works really well. So there's, of course, different solutions to make sure that you have good audio. If you don't have a microphone, microphone, just listen to your surroundings. Make sure there's no reverb or echo, and try to turn off any distracting background noises. Tip four, use the right light. So this is really obvious, but trust me, so often it goes wrong. Often what you only have to do is face a window and just look. All I'm doing is facing a window and look at the difference it makes. This looks so much more professional than when I was faced the other way. And all I did was change my angle. So that's what I really want you to look at when you're making one of your very first videos, is look at the light. What are your natural light sources? Do you have any windows? Can you go outside? And can you try to face the light? Can you try to face a window? This can make such a big difference in how professional your video looks, and also in how you can establish that connection and make sure that your message is actually coming across. So make sure you check the light. Then also, as a second step, oftentimes your camera, your smartphone will actually do this pretty well. But if not, so maybe you're looking into the camera and the light is a little bit off. On most phones, you simply tap your screen. So I'm tapping my screen in different spots now. And as you can see, the light becomes different. Woo! Wherever I tap it. So you tap it usually on your eyes, which is what I just did. And then the exposure and the focus will be adjusted to my face. So that is another tip that I really want to give you. On most iPhones, you can also move that little sun you see right next to the square. And on most Androids, there's a light bulb that you can move. And then you can also manually change your light. Tip number five for filming with your smartphone is use the right framing. Whether you are filming a person or perhaps an object with your phone, if you use the right framing, so the right distance and the right angle, that can make all the difference. Okay, first of all, let me show you how to not put a person on camera. So what a lot of people do when they film someone is kind of like this, really far away, lots of space above the head and a lot of space next to you. What you really want to do is move a bit closer than maybe you want. So move up a lot closer, maybe here, and then stand kind of on the side. This is also what I'm using here is the rule of thirds. So you might have seen this on your phone. A lot of phones have a grid and you can turn it on or off, but those are lines on the screen. And pretty much what you want to do is use those lines and stand on one of those lines. So you don't stand right in the middle, but a little on the side, and you can do this in interviews as well. You want to, of course, look into the camera lens, not look at yourself, but look into the camera lens. So you make that eye contact, and then you have a lot more space here to also put pictures and text, and there's more background space as well. So this is a good way to frame a person, whether it's you or someone you're interviewing. Now let's talk about perhaps you want to film something, maybe this book. Maybe you want to film an album with a lot of different pictures. How would you do that? So one of the things that you can do is just hold it right next to you. You know, that's one way. You can also film it separately. And then in an app, put those pictures, put your video next to or over this video. So what you can do is, of course, make close-up shots of the book. You can film, I'll show you. You can film from different distances and angles. So say I'm filming this book with this phone. First of all, I can make a shot like this. This distance, this angle. Secondly, I could make a shot like this. This is also called eagle eye. So I'm right above it looking down. I could also do the other way, maybe an angle like this, from beneath on an angle. I can also do a shot like this and perhaps a slow-mo or maybe a time lapse. Or I could, well, this is going to be difficult when you're by yourself. You need a little tripod for this, but you can hold the phone and then perhaps flip through the book, for example, so you have some movement.
As you can see, what you want to do is try to think of creative, different ways to film an object. So instead of just holding it, try to think of this in different ways. How can I film this in an interesting way? Close up, further away, from above, from below, maybe with a time lapse, maybe with a slow motion, maybe with some movement. So I can hold the camera here and then just put the book over here. So try to think of different ways to film things, and that can really make your video a lot more dynamic. Tip number 6 is use the right apps. The great thing with your phone is you have everything in one device. You can film with it, edit it, and publish it all from your phone. Okay, my favorite apps of the moment are, first of all, Quick. Q-U-I-K without a C. This is a great app for iPhone and Android, and it's free. It's great to make simple compilation videos. Perhaps you have a bunch of pictures and videos already on your phone or on your computer. Well, try to get them on your phone, and then with Quick, you can easily make a video out of them. You just put them in the app and Quick, whoop, make something out of it. Trust me, it's a great app. Check it out. So that's Quick. If you want to have a bit more control over your video, maybe you have interviews, maybe it's you doing a little vlog, so you want to have a bit more control over the length of clips and perhaps adding some text in or music or whatever it is, then I can also really recommend iMovie and KineMaster, because with those apps, you can edit in layers. They're really wonderful. So those are the first couple of apps you want to use. And if then you think, well, maybe I want to spice it up a little bit and add some graphics or some text or my logo, I can really recommend the app InShot. So what you do is you first create a video, perhaps in iMovie, and then you export it to your camera roll. Then you import it again in InShot, and perhaps there you can add your logo and maybe a few words here and there. And that can really help your video pop. And my final tip is make sure you caption your videos. And there are amazing apps out there that caption the video for you automatically. So if you have an Android phone, there's AutoCap. If you have an iPhone, then there's Mix Captions. And these apps are really amazing. So once your video is done, it's finished, you export it, obviously, then you import it in either AutoCap or Mix Captions. And then the app listens to your audio, transcribes the clip for you, and automatically captions the video for you. You can, of course, change the captions a little bit, and then you export it, and your video is captioned. It's really amazing. I use it all the time for my videos that I use on LinkedIn as well. It does cost a little bit of money. I think I paid maybe 10 or 20 euros 3 months ago. And I publish a video every week, and I'm still using the same credit. So I think it's probably less than a euro or less than a dollar for each video, depending on the length of your video, of course. So the longer your video, the more credits it's going to cost. But it's really, really not that expensive, and I think worth every single. So I hope these tips helped and convinced you that you can do everything with your phone. You can film, edit, and publish with a camera in your pocket. My name is Palpina, and I would love to connect with you. There's a lot more that I can show you, so definitely check out my website for a ton of free tools. For now, have fun making videos.
Hello, my name is Céleste. I am sharing these slides with you as a teaser for a program that I'm creating at the moment called the Unique Branded Blueprint. The reason why I'm doing this is because I want to empower entrepreneurs and scale-ups to understand how important it is to find a registerable trademark. And I'm going to show now not only them, and I'm not going to talk about what it says on these slides. I'm just going to show them to you to sort of pique your interest, as it were, in to perhaps wanting to join this program of mine. As I said before, it's called the Unique Branded Blueprint. And here are the various elements of it. Takes a bit of time. All right, here we go. Sorry about that. So these are the various elements, and I'm not going to go into detail with what they mean. This is just to sort of pique your interest, as it were. And as you can tell from this slide, it's really, really important to find a registrable trademark and to actually have it registered. And there are several things that can happen if you don't. And there are several things that can happen when you do. So it's really, really important to get something like this program and partake in it. And here is a picture of me. And I am an award-winning trademark specialist. I am also a master of law, a public speaker, and I am the author of the book Control Your Own Copyright, Trademark, and More. And there is my logo for Grand IPR. Here's another slide. And here are my contact details. So I want to thank you for paying attention to this little presentation of mine that I created for Andrea's benefit for the empowerment summit that she is creating at the moment. So feel free to reach out to me either on LinkedIn or through my website. And please follow my business page. Oh, there are actually some YouTube channels. You can find them on LinkedIn. You can even search for the Empress of Trademarks, which is my nickname. I didn't put that on this slide. I do apologize for that. This is something I have created on the fly for Andrea after a brief conversation with her today on the 12th of September. That's how fast I work at times. I'm actually in the middle of doing something with or creating this 12-week program. Anyway, thank you for listening. Over and out. Bye.
Okay, go. Shoot your shot. Right now? Okay.
You know, instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around through ups and downs, you know, I just said, look. We'll be right back.
Hello, everyone. My name is Maria Bremen, and I'm a Reiki practitioner of both Western and Eastern styles. My main focus always has been to help people find balance. I've been thinking a lot how to do this introductional speech and how to raise your attention for what I'm going to present you with. So I would start simply saying a few words that the year 2020 was the most challenging year I ever faced with. A couple of years ago, I switched career. I quit my job. I quit my full-time job at a huge company. And with shaky hands, I started my own company called Brighten Up with Reiki. And it's been challenging, but it wasn't as tough as it was now in the year of 2020. Because of the coronavirus, my business became compromised. And I could have chosen to be completely go under myself and look for some kind of a job where I'll try to survive and make my living, or I can carry on with my business, creating a new platform. And I did the latter. I believe that self-empowerment, not only women's empowerment, but self-empowerment is extremely important. And when you have so many tasks in your life, you don't even know where to focus at. And the only thing that kept me going and sane was the body clock. Keeping simple rules of what time of the day is the best for what activity made so much sense. It was much easier for me to create a calendar on a daily basis and dedicate where I should invest most of my energy doing certain things. That's why I am sharing the body clock video with you, because I believe that everybody must know more about their own bodies. They should find the balance between body and mind, because body and mind is all we have. And this is the only thing that we can empower. And if we can do that, we can help to empower anybody else around us. I hope you will enjoy this video. And yeah, you shall see. Thank you. Bye.
Hello there. My name is Stefan Taylor, and I'd like to give you my own welcome to this amazing online summit that Andrew's put together over this 4 days. Now, what I'd like to share with you today is both some of my own personal struggles and some of which may even resonate with you in terms of the challenges we face on a day-to-day basis and how we can question ourselves, put doubt in our own mind, which leads on to generating a lack of confidence, a lack of self-esteem, a lack of self-belief, when we know, or after we've set ourselves goals in life, personal goals, health goals, well-being goals, business goals, whatever that may be. I'd like to share with you some of my own struggles of really finding my own identity, my identity. I'm coming to you from the UK, not so sunny today, and I'm sat here in what I call my little super shed. And it's been a hell of a journey to get here, to get to this moment where I'm speaking to you guys today. You see, I am and was born into an amazing, loving parental family relationship where my mum is white, an amazing, strong white woman. And my dad is black, an amazing, strong black man from Barbados. In the UK, being the minority, it very quickly became apparent to me that I was in the minority at a very early age. And recognizing that I stood out a little bit, I wasn't the same as all the rest of my friends. And to add to that, I'm also vertically challenged. I am short. So this was another battle I had in my own head to be able to generate strength, which I struggled with, to generate self-belief, which I struggled with, to generate self-esteem, which I struggled with, in terms of finding my own identity. Who am I? Where do I fit in amongst all of my friends and everyone I look around at who look the same? And I didn't. Now, the reason why I want to share that with you is because that's where my own struggle with self-identity really began, from a very early age of 8, 9, 10, 11 years old. Understanding that you are different, and this sort of links into why I do what I do now. I work with women who are going through perimenopause or menopause, and they're struggling to find their own identity, struggling to find their self-esteem, struggling to find their self-confidence, because so many things change during that period of your life as a woman that you can lose some of that connection to who you were before. It creates blocks in self-belief. Can I actually do these things? Am I good enough? Do I deserve the things that I've set out to achieve? What it also led me to do a lot is for me to create within myself a helper type behavior pattern. What I mean by that is that in order for me to mask my own insecurities, my own inability to understand why I was struggling with my own identity, I developed a helper type behavior pattern where I would help others first. And again, that's something that I recognize in mums particularly, and women going through perimenopause and menopause. Because in order to mask how you actually feel, you can do it very effectively by helping other people more. It stops you thinking about yourself. It puts a lid on those feelings that are quite hard to A, understand, and B, to be able to give some sort of clarity to. I find it very difficult, and still find it very difficult, after what's happened and keeps happening over the years, with lives being taken of people in minority situations and it being splashed all over the media, I find it very hard to understand why we have to stand up and justify why our lives are worth it, why our lives really matter. And again, it's something I see in the ladies I work with, is that they feel they have to justify putting themselves first, putting their health first, putting their well-being first, because of the way that society shapes girls into teenagers, into young women, into mothers. Here in the UK, I'm not sure whether this is a worldwide organization, but the Brownies and the Guides is an organization for girls to go and be part of a community, grow, share experiences, earn badges, try new things they maybe wouldn't have done if they hadn't have joined this group. But one thing I struggle to understand with regards to that is that a young girl, maybe 7, 8, 9 years old, maybe going to the Brownies, and the Brownie law states that you should always put others first. Now, ultimately, when you're told this message from a very early age, then you believe that to be the truth, that you believe that you should put other people first. And how that manifests itself in later life is that you're continuing to do that because you are and have been programmed to believe that to be the truth. So when you actually begin to struggle with losing self-confidence, losing self-esteem, losing some of your identity because your body's changing, and it's not responding the way it used to respond, that you're still putting other people first, and you struggle to put your own health and well-being first. And that resonates with me. I just want to share a quick story with you about an experience I had. And it's very vivid. As a 10-year-old boy, I was a football fanatic. I would play football whenever I had a chance to, and it really began forming the foundations for my love and passion for sport. My team went to a 6-a-side tournament local to where I used to live, and out of all the teams, I was given player of the tournament. I was given a trophy of a footballer stood on a football, and I was so proud of myself. It was the first positive experience of standing out amongst a whole host of maybe 100 other players, and that accolade had been given to me. But that feeling was short-lived. The coach at the time told me that I had to share that trophy with the rest of the team. I'd have to pass it around to the rest of the team members to appreciate that as well. And for that moment of elation where I felt, not because I was expecting anything like that, but just the sheer surprise, shock, and overwhelming pride I had came crashing down. And that sense of achievement was lost as I had to release that trophy. That moment is really vivid in my mind. And understanding how that put doubt, questioned my abilities at such an early age then ran through my teenage years as I struggled with education. As I struggled to locate my own self-identity. Now, I share that story with you for the reason that ultimately we can have success in our lives and feel good temporarily. And in the blink of an eye, someone can take it away. Unbeknown to them, they've created an avalanche of emotions, feelings that can last for a long time. It's often not done with malice. It's often not done out of spite. But unbeknown to the initiator of that comment, it creates a knock-on effect for many years to come. I understand that it takes a great deal of effort, commitment, and time to be able to understand where your identity comes from. To understand that we all have deep within us the strength to be able to continue and carry out the goals and intentions we set ourselves, no matter how big, no matter how small. So when I work with ladies who are struggling with self-identity, when I work with ladies who are struggling with self-esteem, when I work with ladies who are struggling to put themselves first, I let them know it's okay. Because ultimately the payoff, which I've learned myself, is that the better I take care of my own physical and psychological well-being, the better I can help others, the better I can guide, mentor, coach, teach those people around me. Because deep down, I'm still and always will be a helper type person. And that's what I share with the ladies and mothers that I work with. Is as you learn and understand how to reconnect with self, how to reconnect with your self-esteem, self-confidence, and belief, then that gives you the ability, an abundance of energy and drive, and further fans the flames to be able to help those you love the most. Part of me sits here, and on a day-to-day basis, I am concerned about the health and fitness industry on a whole, as a whole, because the majority of this industry that I'm so passionate about and have been in for the last 20 years is all about the quick fix. It's all about giving ladies a solution which works temporarily. But what then? The quick fix seems appealing, it seems tempting, it seems like the answer. I'm not sure what your experiences are of managing your health, managing your weight, starting new exercise regimes. But ultimately, the majority of you out there who are listening would have experienced going on a diet, starting an exercise regime, and it being great for the first few weeks or a couple of months, and then you can't sustain it. Because ultimately, in order to create lasting change, in order to understand what is ultimately important to you, it's about channeling your energy into creating a better connection to your inner self, for you to be able to glow from the inside out. So you're not and we're not, as a global nation, constantly searching for that next dopamine hit, for that next like, click to appear on our social media, which gives you that dopamine hit, instant, for that quick fix diet that you've just started, means that you lose some weight initially and then you gain it back and more. That constant yo-yo, that roller coaster ride that so many people live on and believe to be the true nature of moving forwards and progressing. It's about moving away from that dopamine hit and connecting with your serotonin, the natural warming glow of inner happiness that helps manage your mental health, helps suppress depression, helps improve the quality of your sleep, and connects with your immune system to keep you safe from all of what we are going through at the moment. Connecting internally, being able to glow from the inside out, means that you no longer have to show that external mask of happiness. I was chatting with a client of mine this morning who has been through an awful time, who shows that external face of it's okay. Internally, it's extremely painful. But what also comes with that is you recognize how uncomfortable it is when people move into your personal space, because we radiate energy away from us. And other humans can sense that subconsciously. Have you ever been in the presence of someone who's smiling, but you just sense something? You sense something isn't right. They look okay, but you sense there's something wrong because you've moved into their energy space. And it's just giving off some sort of maybe negativity. And when I say negativity, maybe sadness or loneliness or confusion. And we sense that as humans and we ask a question, are you okay? Are you sure you're okay? So the client I was speaking to today, I said, how do you feel about people getting too close? She doesn't like it. Because people can sense beyond the external face, the external smile of it's okay. They can sense when they get too close that something's not right. And it leads to it inviting questions. And in order to prevent those questions coming forwards, she prevents people coming too close. The solution for creating long-term health is about understanding how we feel inside, what we want to achieve from deep down, and not being afraid of speaking it. I don't mean necessarily sharing it with others. I mean just saying it out loud to yourself or even writing it down and asking the question why after each sentence you write. Something as simple as, I want to lose 5 kilos in weight. Why? I feel I'll be able to move and be more active with my children. Why? It makes me happy when I can keep up with the children in the garden. Why? Because I want to be a role model for my children as they grow up. Why? Because as a parent, I want to be able to guide them and help them into their future. Why? Because I love them. So it's not just about that initial goal. It's about understanding how you get to the layers beneath it, to that why that will truly inspire you to change yourself from where you are to ultimately where you want to be. And that's been my journey. And I didn't really connect with that challenge or face up to that challenge, have the confidence to look at who I was until the age of 40. Now at 47, I'm now beginning to understand much more about myself, feel more confident. This is why I can sit here and chat with you today. Because deep inside, there is still that part of me that says you're not good enough to be speaking on this platform. And I have to listen to that voice, that devil on my shoulder. And I have to quietly thank it for reminding me that I'm human. We all have those doubts and parts of our personality that will question whether we're good enough to do, say, and be what we strive to be. There is a way forward. There is a way to achieve everything you've set out to achieve. Be strong. Have an abundance of energy, health, vitality to achieve the business goals, lifestyle goals, family goals that you may set yourself for now and for the future. And ultimately to take care of those loved ones that surround you. Just to wrap up, I'd like to say if there are any questions you'd like answering, if you have doubts and you recognize there are parts of you that you would like to understand more about, to help generate a greater level of connection to self, your health, your well-being, your outlook, then please get in touch. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening to what has been partly my story of why I'm here today. Have an awesome rest of the summit. Enjoy whichever workshops, presentations that you drop into. Wherever you are around the world. Bye-bye.
Hi, my name is Wasim Dabusi, CEO and co-founder of the Muslim Boss Movement. I'm a serial entrepreneur, passionate father, and loving husband. I'm passionate about making people the best version of themselves and elevating the world's consciousness. I'm also an advocate for harmonious and happy families. Meet my partner, Rizwana Yusuf, CEO and co-founder of the Muslim Boss Movement. Rizwana is also an award-winning entrepreneur. She's passionate about teaching about entrepreneurship and is an advocate for mental health and a holistic lifestyle. Rizwana is also a loving wife and mother of two. Now, you're in the right place if you are running yourself into the ground by over-delivering but undercharging your worth. You may be feeling inadequate as you don't understand the right and effective way to grow a successful business that you love without the burnout. You may also be comparing yourself to others in your industry and secretly feeling jealous. Today, we are going to cover the three secrets that every successful entrepreneur as well as self-made billionaires know and use every single day so that they can do, be, and have anything that they've ever wanted to. And you too can achieve the same level of success by following these secrets. We're going to learn how you can make money using your existing talents and skills. We're also going to uncover the one thing that you need to master before you spend time, money, and energy on your business, and a way that you can reach a global audience from the comfort of your own home around your existing lifestyle. You see, surely I knew there's going to be a better way, but I Googled and searched and I could not find one single business community that encompasses the three things that we believe are the basis for entrepreneurial success. So this is why I started my search and started founding the Muslim Boss Movement. Today, we will cover the three secrets. The number one is that you are already an expert without even realizing it. Number two, mindset is everything, and mindset is also nothing. And number three, making global impact from your laptop is possible for you. You see, already you have vast and deep wisdom and knowledge. You have existing knowledge and the power to position yourself as an expert to teach the world, and you may not even realize it. You may not even realize that you can reach and have a global impact, and all that you need is the right direction of where to find your tribe. Now, take a look at these famous scientists and billionaires who stopped short of having a degree. However, had they not moved forward and taken the leap, we would not be able to enjoy the impact that they've had on the world. People like Edison, the Wright brothers, and Bill Gates all took a leap of faith and believed in themselves. You see, your brain has a negativity bias to protect you from harmful things. That's your fight or flight response. And this is great to keeping you alive. However, this is not so great for growth and success. And it gives you a lot of negative messaging and programming about who you are. Because when you do something that is outside of your comfort zone, your lizard brain kicks in. Your autopilot, fight or flight. You feel uncomfortable, so your brain rejects it and it stops it from the discomfort. You find excuses to not move forward and you block yourself around not putting yourself out there because you may feel like a show-off. What you need to do is to break through these limiting beliefs. You need to remove the T from I can't to become I can, and look at what beliefs are getting in your way. How can you flip the switch on those old beliefs? Prioritize a mindset of self-belief, self-worth, and growth. Write yourself a new script. What does the new confident version of you look like? Be that version of who you already have, who you already know has the success that's already inside you. Put in a daily mindset practice. Get support when needed, and you'll be surprised how fast results can happen. Now, making money online may seem impossible. However, what we know in today's world, it is possible, and thousands of entrepreneurs have been able to make a global impact and make money online through their laptops and their computers. And this is also possible for you if you know how to do it. The first thing you've got to do is find your tribe. There are millions and millions of people out there. And in today's technology with laptops and mobiles, we can reach thousands, if not hundreds and millions of people within seconds if we know where to look for them. And that is the power of globalization. Take a moment to think about Facebook. Facebook has over 2 billion active users alone. Instagram has over 800 million active users. TikTok also has 800 million active users. LinkedIn, on the other hand, also has over 80 million active users. Now, do you think your tribe is there? So what we've covered so far today is, number one, you are an expert, and all that you need to do is change your mindset and believe in the skills and talents that you already have. And number three, well, that was number two, the changing your mindset. Number three is that you can make a global impact from the comfort of your own home through your laptop. So I'd like to ask you a question. Has this resonated with you? Are any of these secrets or any of these three things that we've discussed today things that you know are holding you back? If you answered yes or any of these resonated with you, I have good news for you today. And that good news is the Muslim Boss Movement. This is why we started the Muslim Boss Movement, because this is a revolutionary movement surrounded by confident, motivated entrepreneurs just like you, who are there to support each other and have done the things that you want to achieve. Because what we know is success leaves clues. So right now, you have two choices. Take a leap of faith or do nothing. If you do nothing, nothing will change. But if you want to take that leap of faith and find out what your personality, what your boss personality is, just go to bit.ly/mbm personality and take the quiz.
It began with a bold vision to build KL Metropolis, a development that would establish a new international trade and exhibition district in Malaysia, built in partnership with the government by NAZA Group's property arm, NAZA TTDI. The crown jewel of this grand vision is the Malaysia International Trade and Exhibition Centre, the preferred international destination for exhibitions and events. Like the fine gold and silver threads of the Songket weave that inspired its facade design, MyTech is the embodiment of refined craftsmanship, creativity and precision. As Malaysia's largest exhibition centre, MyTech's functional spaces are unprecedented. Primed for exceptional displays, surrounded by state-of-the-art facilities and amenities. This iconic structure affirms a commitment to innovative excellence. It is a showpiece of engineering ingenuity. An enduring icon built for a new Malaysian era of success.
It's time to think differently about empowerment. Let's create a definition together. What does empowerment mean to you? Join the Global Online Women Empowerment Summit from the 1st until the 4th of October. We include everyone in the conversation. Celebrate diversity with us. 70 plus experts from all around the world, more than 45 hours of value to take away. Entertainment, panel discussions, interviews, debates, networking opportunities, kids' corner, cooking shows, wellness sessions, and so much more. Embrace your feminine side. Lose labels and judgment. Give your power to others and grow together. 4 days to connect for families in difficult situations, for women entrepreneurs, for elderly, and for youth. We will approach the different topics from empowerment points of view. We will talk about cultures, traditions, societies, families, relationships, education, mental health, wellness, cyberbullying, future, social media, marketing, business, career, and profession. The three main goals of the summit are closing the generation gaps between the elderly and the youth, to talk about the future of families and how homepreneurs and home business will take over. And the third thing is women empowerment, how we shift from women empowerment to empowerment and how we can embrace our feminine energy. Empower others right now. Bring the summit to those who couldn't access without your help.
Hi guys, welcome to the Global Women Empowerment Summit, the Youth Power Session, where we talk about the press button. In this session, we'll be discussing about what made our young entrepreneurs press the start button. So with me, I have Irfan and I have Rohan. Say hi guys.
Hi.
Hey guys.
Rohan,
hello.
So Rohan is a 22-year-old full-time university student and a part-time beauty guru and a Mary Kay independent beauty consultant. Whereas Irfan is a 21-year-old freelance photographer and a co-founder of ReStory, which is a digital marketing agency. Irfan, do you want to tell us something about you?
Hi guys. My name is Roman Irfan, media nomad. So I am 21 years old now. I graduated my diploma in mass communication last year, August. So currently I'm just freelancing. So I'm a freelance photographer and a videographer. And I also work for productions as a camera assist. And I'm co-founder of the company called ReStory. So in ReStory, we are a digital marketing company where we work with companies to market their social media. So we do social media maintenance, so we can do advertising video for them, a short description video, and also like a teaser video for their daily feed for the Instagram or Facebook, whichever platform they are using. Most of the clients nowadays, they are more into Instagram because the growing youth nowadays, they are more towards Instagram. So we are more towards Instagram nowadays, and more in Facebook. We don't use Facebook much, but there are also many people using Facebook. We use Facebook to check audience, what type of audience are using who gets access to our page. So that's what we do, yeah.
What about you, Rohan? Tell us, what is Rohan all about? What's the jazz? What's the sass?
Yeah, so hi guys, I'm Rohan. I'm 22 years old. I'm a full-time university student and I'm a part-time beauty guru and a Mary Kay independent beauty consultant. So what basically I do is I provide personalized coaching to individuals on how to take care of their skin and how to use makeup the way they want to, because skincare and makeup are things that is very personal, is very personal to individual, and that is where I bring a very personalized approach where I teach them based on the makeup look that they want and how they would feel confident to put on their makeup. And because skincare is also something that is so personal and on a one-to-one basis, right? So that is where I also provide personalized consulting to help people to settle their skin issues like anti-aging, to also fight acne, to have to do take care of the skin, basic skincare, and also to fight pigmentation, oily skin, dry skin, and all that. And I also coach and lead other women to also start their own medical businesses as well. So yeah, that's what is basically about me.
So basically, Rohan is empowering everybody with their skincare and their beauty looks, while Irfan is empowering people with his ideas and empowering brands especially to grow. So I have a very interesting question for you guys. Okay, you guys are very young. So I want to know, what was the driving force that led you guys to press that start button in your business? Irfan, do you want to go first?
What led me to go for my field basically? Well, a lot of people ask me this question: why this creative industry? Well, how do I say? I mean, like, I got this interest. Like, it's mainly because of the interest. I just like staying behind the camera, and you know, sometimes people go like, "Hey, let's take a photo," and I'm like, "Have you guys seen most of the group photos we take in universities or everything? I mean, there will be people, everyone, and I'm like, okay, I took the photo, by the way." So I'm like, mostly not in the pictures. So I'm the guy who will like always get left behind. And some people post the picture, so won't even give tags. So I mean, like, so it's made me interest, lah. I got to get interest when I was like form one, form two, when I was in secondary school. I was in this club called Media Club, where we used to cover all these school events and stuff. That's where the first time I got the camera. Even that camera was not mine, you know. We used like the club's camera. So I used to go, I mean, I like those type of times where I used to go out in the camera, that assembly is going on. So you're like, you are like the guy holding the camera, going, standing there, taking pictures. It sounded very cool. Then a few times I started doing that, and I was like, hey, actually, and then the teacher started to say, like, hey, you take really good photos. Then I was like, oh, okay, actually someone is really appreciating the work that I do. So that's when I started to take out my own photo. Then I saved some money, of course. Then I bought my own camera back in 2000. I mean, I don't know the year, basically, when I was in Form 3. That was my very first camera I got it for myself. So that camera, I used to bring it out anywhere, you know, because you are in the media club, you can bring the camera to school anytime during the school days. So I used to, I used to bring the camera every time to the school, and I used to take picture of my friends during the classes, PJK time.
So we can literally say, we can literally say that Irfan is always with a camera and never without it, right? Okay, yeah. So we have our new guest here who just joined us. It is nobody else other than Villa. Vila, do you want to say something about yourself?
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi. Sorry. So, guys.
Hi, okay?
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
So, we are live now. So, Vila is a 21-year-old full-time university student, part-time yoga instructor, and a Shalamit independent beauty consultant. Vila, the stage is yours. Let us know what are you all about.
Okay. So, basically, I'm a yoga instructor, a part-time yoga instructor for this center called Ashtanga Yoga Therapy Center. And I started doing yoga practicing as a yoga practitioner when I was around 14 years old. And then it started up like me being just a student. Just a student. And then when I was 16, that's when I took up the master course to start teaching and taking up classes. So my very first class was encouraged by my master herself. Master Logan Aigi, the founder of Ashtanga Yoga Therapy Center. And the first class was taken was the kids yoga in the year 2014, I guess.
Yep. That is so early, guys. This is amazing. So, Vila, to catch you up, we are on our first question, where I will let Rohan tell his two cents. So, Rohan, what was your driving force that made you press the start button?
Well, initially, I just started my journey, right, with makeup, only just to learn makeup because I had an interest in it. And then eventually, after picking up the skills, I started running my Medicaid business and also providing makeup services, right? So eventually, I just pressed the start button, I accelerated is when I realized that I compared a fresh grad salary, right? 2005 is the general market range, right? You'll be earning about 17 ringgit per hour. But while when I'm running my own business, I can make 300 ringgit per hour. And I have the flexibility, the time flexibility, and the be able to be my own boss. So this, this income calculation is what made me press my acceleration button to actually do my business full out. Yeah.
So it wasn't just a button; it was a hold-on pedal. You mean?
It was a hold-on accelerator pedal. I just pressed it all out. Yeah.
So, Vila, what about you? What was the force that made you press your start button, or as Rohan said, the accelerator pedal?
As I said, I started yoga just being a student. I was not a yoga person, and I did not actually imagine myself being in this position, because I'm very bad at business in general. I used to be very bad at business. But then the encouragement from my family, and also most importantly, my Master Loga, she's the accelerate button for me, because like she totally she pushed me into the world of business, and actually told me that I could really I could start up something. And it would not go into a failure. So as I said, business, getting the idea into business was totally her idea. And yes, here I am.
Nice. This is all exciting driving forces behind you guys. One is passion, the want to be your own boss, the other one is just a whole person pushing you to reach your limits or your goals and your capabilities. Now, jumping straight into my second question, I'm very curious about this. How did you guys handle the constant questions or doubts from others and even yourself during whenever that you started? Do you guys ever doubt yourself? What were the questions thrown at you? How did you face it? Tell me. So, go first.
I go first, or you go first?
Anything.
Yeah,
I'll
Ron.
Yes.
Like for me, right? The times where I doubt myself, eventually along the process running my business, I actually accepted Christianity as my faith. So in that process, I actually learned that my purpose in life is to nurture and develop people. So once understanding that is my purpose, right, is to help other people grow, that always made me I will not have doubts about what I do. But it just, when I feel a bit weak, but that purpose also empowers me. But other than that, I also rely back a lot to my faith, where there's a Bible verse that I really strongly hold on to, is where it's called 1 Timothy 4:12, where it says, don't let other people look down on you because of young, but be an example in love, in faith, and in purity. So these are things what I hold on to fight all those self-limiting beliefs and doubts that I have. Yeah.
Irfan, tell me. Nice one, Rohan.
So, well, about myself in this context, well, as I said, before I started doing this freelancing, not even before, but I was doing this freelance photo video thing. So I was also working for some productions for like as camera assist. You know, sometimes like in big film crews, like advertising companies or something, they have this crew. So in the camera department, they usually be a main camera or camera operator. So there'll be this camera operator DP, who is the director of photography. And there'll be a couple of camera assist one, who is the focus puller. Then there will be data transferer, and also like maybe if it's a very big one, they'll have 3-4 camera assists. So in this particular as an example, like in this particular shoot that I went for, it was an advertisement for Scoot Airlines. It's an airline at Singapore. So they came for a shoot at Penang. So it was a 3-day shoot at Penang. So I went for the shoot, and most of the guys who worked there, they were all 30 plus. All of them were 30 plus. The only guy who was 10, at that time I was 20 last year. So I was the only guy 20. So just imagine, we are traveling in van going from KL to Penang. So the whole way trip, I'm surrounded by all the 30s guys sitting around me, and they're smoking in the van. I'm just like sitting down watching them. Okay, guys. Okay. So like, I was just like a small kid, and every day they shoot me. This one guy come and asking me, "You're too young. How are you here?" And I said, "Okay." Then I said, "I got this contact from this person." Then he said, "Okay, that's how I got this contact." Then he'll say, "Okay." Then the questions started coming a lot of times. Like everyone started asking me the same question. And there were also some people who were like, "Oh, it's very good and you're starting at this age. You're clear of what you're doing." So I was like, okay, at that time is when I realized, okay, maybe some people, those guys who I met, they said, actually, how I came into this line is because I didn't know what else to do. So when I got in touch with the right person, they came into this path. So these guys started advising me, saying that, actually, you are going the right path. So you're choosing what you want to do, and you're going the right path, and you're clear of what you're going to do in the future. So that's what made me like even happier to choose what I'm doing. So that's why I'm keep going nowadays. Like I'm getting like projects and everything. So that's what motivates me and stuff. That's how I solve all the problems, how they ask me and questions. Yeah.
Villa.
All right,
so, what's your take on this?
Okay. So from my side, as I said, like, yoga was totally new to me. Like, thank God I started up with kids yoga, because like till today, there's always questions, there's always doubts from everyone around me that, hey, how can you become a yoga instructor at this young age? Because like usually we see around, look at, you know, TV, I mean, like this kind of programs and stuff. Every time you see a yoga instructor at the age of 40 and above, 50 and above, so they tend to, the questions they get when they see a young girl over there is like, hey, are you sure you're really a yoga instructor? Or are you really qualified? Like, because when I went to take my yoga master certificate, that we have a certificate on, to, I mean, like, we have to take the certificate before we start teaching. I was the youngest over there. So when I was taking that, the entire team looked very differently at me. And at the same time, you don't have to see the students. Typically, the students, like, they look at you and they were like, okay, this girl looks very young. Like, okay, is she? Because we have the ethics where, how young you are also when you're going to teach them in yoga, you have to call the instructor in front of you as a teacher or a master. So some of them actually feel very, how to say, they feel very uncomfortable calling a very, very young girl to them as master. So always this kind of question has been popped up. He has doubts into their heads, and till today, I do get this kind of questions and doubts from all my students. Like, okay, are you really a yoga instructor, or how young how young have become like, you know, a yoga instructor. How can a yoga instructor be so young? And I'm like, okay. but then all this has actually, all these questions have actually pushed me through it, to bring me actually to this kind of a level. I've just passed all those questions and right, I'm here. Yes. Basically, you know, when we tend to get questioned, right, this kind of questions, that is like one of our, like a threat to us, which we can actually overcome it. Yeah. So this kind of doubts and questions was one of my biggest threats.
Okay, so can I say this, based on all three of the answers that you guys have given me, that the way that we handle the doubts from within us and from others is basically the love for our passion and the need to prove people wrong and to show people that you can do it. Am I right? Am I saying this right? So,
yes.
I love whatever sharing that you guys have done. I can definitely relate to you guys. My last question for this cute session is, what would you do with your business if you had no financial barriers? You are free from all your financial barriers. What are the little things that you could do with your business? Short ones. Rohan, you want to go first?
No, financial barriers as in like unlimited. Are we speaking in a limit here or unlimited? How is it spoken here? No limits, basically.
Unlimited. Bottomless.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think Rohan, you should go first.
For me, what I would do if there's, I have all the money I want in the world to invest in my business, is that I will open a training center to train all my beauty consultants, my team members, all my students, so that there's a place for us to gather together and work together to grow our business even more. So that's what I do. I'll open a training center / office.
Wow. Rohan is all out to empower everybody, right?
Yeah, that's my mission. Yeah, so that, you know, I can hold a big quantity of people in my office. That's really what I want.
I love it. Irfan, go. What would you do?
I totally support Rohan. That's the first thing I'll do too. Because as I said, we are like working from homes, and we get to meet each other whenever we have work, we have projects. That's the only time we get to meet each other. So it is the best place to get. I mean, it's very good to get a place for us where we can sit down together and work. And also, I'll invest the money. I mean, invest the money on softwares to where we can. Where we can use it on social media pages, where we can track our audience better. So even when we have this type of software, we will get to understand our audience better. So when we get to understand our audience better, we can provide the clients better to give them a better result on what they are searching for. And also, I'll invest on a better computer and stuff in the office. And that's a compulsory thing, when I mentioned the software part. So the computer all comes in when I talk about it.
Yeah.
So yeah, that I think that's what I'll do.
Very, very driven towards improving yourself and your team, I suppose, right?
Yeah. I mean, when I talk about the team, I also mean, I forgot to mention this part. When we talk about the camera equipment, you know, nowadays these camera equipment are very super damn expensive, you know. So like, even though you get a camera and the lens, it's already about 20-30k. So I think I'll get a couple of those just as stocky, so you can just give your friends to come and shoot. I think that's what I'll do.
nice. Basically creating new opportunities for people with the resources that you have.
Yes.
Willa, I'm very curious about what you would say. Would you probably open a whole new yoga center for all the kids?
Yeah, that's everyone's dream, being a coach for something, right? So obviously, if I do not have any financial barriers, the first thing I would do is to open a center which I can, help many people, first of all. And also, yoga, as you guys know, yoga is an exercise for people who actually come with some problem, health issues or mental issues or physical issues, something. So in all this, I just want to help this kind of people. And at the moment, at our current era, we a lot of people, we suffer from mental depression, actually. Pinpointing to that particular matter, I would like to actually help people with this kind of mental depression.
God bless you.
At the moment, my target is only around Malaysia, but then yes, if there's no financial barriers, then internationally.
This is amazing. I love that I had this session with you guys. It was so nice to hear all your empowerment motives, even though it may sound it may be from different different lines of work, different paths. I can definitely say that you guys are definitely out there to empower people, empower kids, empower young adults, and empower just anybody. And with that, I would like to conclude our session today. Thank you so much for joining us today, guys. Bye.
You're welcome. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
It began with a bold vision to build KL Metropolis, a development that would establish a new international trade and exhibition district in Malaysia, built in partnership with the government by Naza Group's property arm, Naza TTDI. The crown jewel of this grand vision is the Malaysia International Trade and Exhibition Center, the preferred international destination for exhibitions and events. Like the fine gold and silver threads of the Songket weave that inspired its facade design, MyTech is the embodiment of refined craftsmanship, creativity, and precision. As Malaysia's largest exhibition center, MyTech's functional spaces are unprecedented. Primed for exceptional displays, surrounded by state-of-the-art facilities and amenities. This iconic structure affirms a commitment to innovative excellence. It is a showpiece of engineering ingenuity. An enduring icon built for a new Malaysian era of success.
Yes, so we are going for a little break, but soon we are coming back with a surprise and with all the experts. So see you soon.